where everyone seems to congregate. Not that surprising, really.
I do enjoy this exciting new lifestyle I've adopted. Did I ever tell you about my journey to Lindo?
Yes, you did.
Oh, right. I'm sure you have the saga thoroughly memorized.
Oh, yes.
Say, you do some sort of art things, don't you?
Yes.
Do you think you could capture my sheer magnificence on canvas? I'm dying to show my friends what a remarkable traveler I've become.
Okay, I can do that, yes.
What stunning taste you have. Be sure to capture every bit of my elegance.
Well. That should do the trick. Well, I wasn't expecting this. Apparently, I'm not only an artist, but a magician.
Oh my. That painting. It's the most perfect thing I've ever seen. I simply must have it.
Well, for the right price.
This is wonderful. My friends will be so jealous of me. I think I'll start a collection of paintings just like this. Can you imagine? An entire wall filled with paintings of me.
I mean, yes, I can imagine it. It's just I don't particularly want to. But I'm glad you like it. Anyway.
The salty sea air never gets old.
Indeed. It seems like we have some...
Certainly.
...extra glowstones now. I might buy some of this meadow spice mead later, just to see what it does. Okay, so... this door is now... open. Fabric, another candle, and a book. Shadian Folktales Volume 1. And it has inspired us. Long ago, the air outside the planet grew terribly cold. Without any fur or feathers for protection, sun began to freeze. She decided to make her flames as big and hot as possible to keep herself warm. Sun worked all day and night to keep her fires burning. Enormous flames reached all the way around, all the way out to our soil and began to scorch the creatures here. Fires raged, destroying homes and forests, but Sun was too exhausted to notice. Growing worried, the plants and creatures decided to help her. Together they gathered twigs, leaves, fur and feathers and wove them all together into a large sheet of fabric. They covered it with clay to protect it from fire, and the trees lifted the woven mass into the sky. "Take this blanket to rest yourself in warmth," the creatures cried. Sun slipped under the blanket and wrapped herself tightly. Her flames cooled and dimmed, leaving the land creatures in darkness. When Sun woke up from her nap, a golden light returned to the creatures, who danced and sang, thankful that their gift had worked. So that is the story of Sun's blanket, which she still uses each day. Isn't that quaint? When should I wake? Well, let's wait until morning. Let's That's pretty good. A nice long rest. New day begins. And it looks like everyone's out already. Excellent. Well, I'm going to try some of that,
certainly.
Mead. And there we go. I guess we better skip to it. We didn't make the progress we wanted to. So, and now we should have enough to cross. Pay the toll of 60 glowstones? Yes. And across we go. That wasn't too bad. A quaint little home here. Boards. Poor boards. Anyway, there's a book here to read as well. Botanist's Guide to Eastshade, 3rd edition. Crassula mutantis, commonly known as bloomsack, is native to the Lindo region of Eastshade. The blossoms of the bloomsack are fully enclosed and filled with a mixture of air, viscous sap, and seeds. Upon reaching full size, blossoms fall to the ground and split open, allowing for reseeding. If prepared correctly, the sap may be consumed as a beverage, often referred to as bloomsack tea. The blossoms develop a hard skin when harvested, making them ideal for use as flotation devices. That's good to know. Let's see if anyone's in here. And apparently this has inspired us. I can kind of tell why. Some old boards. Candle, a sleeping person. This is not creepy at all. Just going into someone's home while they're asleep and stealing their broken stuff. I guess we can go back to the fellow in a little while. Well, that's different. But here we go. We have enough boards now to make 2 new canvases. So we'll make use of that. And there's a stick. Look like a fellow who knows a thing or two. What are you sitting on?
It is a bloomsack, Ralph.
Interesting. Did you make it?
I did.
Will you teach me how?
I might, but only if you meet the right requirements.
Okay.
My only requirement is that you be my friend. One of my best friends, to be exact.
I mean, of course, I think we'll be great friends.
Don't be hasty. We've only just met.
There are some things I need to know about you first.
That's fair enough. All right.
Is your favourite colour orange or yellow?
Ooh, well, Now, if those are the two choices... I think I would go with orange.
I see. Now, if you had to choose between eating slugs or cakes, which would you eat?
Well, I mean... I guess I'd rather eat the cakes.
Maybe I can make you some slug cakes.
Maybe you could.
This next one will be tricky.
Okay.
If you saw a frog stranded all alone on a lily pad, what would you do?
I think I would leave it be.
That is rather heartless. Don't let the frogs hear you speaking that way. I feel as if I have come to know you very well. Would you agree that we can be friends now?
Think. Weak. I don't see why not.
Oh, wondrous. Here. Now we can sit on rafts together. You'll need some twine to keep it all together. I don't know how to make that, but owner has a lot of it.
Thanks, Bojan, even though you didn't actually introduce yourself.
We also need wax, and that's very hard to find. Sometimes there's stale candles. But don't tell owner.
You know, you really shouldn't steal. Says the person that just went into owner's house and stole a bunch of old things. I wonder if the fellow's up yet. The fellow is indeed up yet. And they're over there. Okay.
Oh, hello there. Mind the plants underfoot.
Okay.
I overheard your conversation with Bojan. He'll be so excited to have you as a friend. He's a very special individual.
There's
no one who loves rafting as much as he does. Though he can be difficult at times, he's a kind soul. I appreciate your cordialness.
Sir, could you tell me how to make twine?
Ah, a blossoming botanist, I see. To start, you'll need some roots. You can find them at the bases of trees. I can show you how to make twine, but it is a process.
You're
a painter. I would so love some artwork in my home. I'm quite partial to sandy beaches. What do you say? If you make me a painting, I'll teach you how to make twine.
I'll see what I can do.
I look forward to seeing your work.
Okay. What can you tell me of Lindo, seeing as we're here?
We've got great plant diversity, and I can always get imported teas from the storehouse. We've also got more wild bloom sacks than anywhere else.
What can you tell me of Nava?
Believe it or not, I've never been. I'm not sure Bojan would care much for the bustle.
Have you heard anything about the architect of Lindo?
As far as I know, he left Lindo a long time ago and never returned. Unfortunately, he and I did not get along terribly well.
Yeah, I've heard that a lot about him. Well, goodbye.
Find the plants underfoot!
Yeah. So you want a sandy beach. I think... if memory serves, we might be able to get something. Actually... I'm going to have to get on the other side of the other side of the river. Because there's a fork just up here. I believe the sandy beach is on the other side. Oops. Well, there's another little house over here. Annika's house. and there's more boards hiding behind the house. Let's see if I can make use of them. Wonderful. More roots too. Nothing I can make use of there. It looks like there's a board. Eastshade and black thistle, protected under the rule of the land. Do not pick, pluck, or pull. Ah. Well then. I guess there's one flower that I can't make use of. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Ah. There is indeed someone here.
I saw some birds flying around a few nights ago. They were so graceful. I especially like the ones that do this. Ooh, ooh.
Owls.
What a fun way to talk. Ooh.
Okay. What can you tell me of Nava?
Fancy, fancy city folk. But they do buy my pots.
Oh, so you're a potter. Good to know.
Bye now.
You're not using these rather janky looking boxes, are you? Well, you're not anymore. Ooh, mushroom. I'm sure that will be fine. Ah. It appears that tower there is responsible for that line. The line of which we can zip. Let's go check it out. Middle tower. Okay. Well then. So we can definitely make use of it somehow. It's now just a matter of working out the how. Well, well, what's going on down here then? There we go. Apparently I needed a jump there. And I can't talk to you. I'm well and truly off the beaten path now. I mean, that thistle is red, so that should be fine. I'll leave it alone, seeing as I don't know the area all too well. Now, this looks like something I need to paint. But from where? Yes, I definitely want to get that water feature in it, and I want to try and get that building. Yes, this looks fine. Okay. Yep, that's what I want to paint. Actually, let's make it a little taller. There we go. Should have used that mead. Mother's Memorial Paintings. You've painted one of Mother's most beloved places. To keep it safe, preserve her memory in her painting menu. Okay. You've chosen to paint over one of your painting. Be sure this is what you want to do before proceeding with this painting. Anika wants a bird with a distinctive hoot. There's definitely some hooting around here. There it is. Well then. Am I able to make any more canvases? I am. Excellent. My goodness, that bloom. Well, let's make use of this meadow spice mead. Oh my, this is very trippy. This way. There we go. Excellent. Well, I guess it's time to go back to Annika's house and hand over the painting. I can remember the way back. Especially with this mead taking its effect on my vision.
I just can't stop thinking about those owls I saw.
Stairs.
I wouldn't know. I've never bought a painting before.
That's fine.
You've got a real ear for birds. Let me know if you ever need anything.
Good to know. Glad you like it.
Bye now.
Cheerio. And there's the painting. already had a frame for it and everything. Let's try and get back to that beach quest. My word. There's some nice looking trees. Ken K. Apothecary. Well then. Another cat. And a candle.
Welcome to K&K Apothecary, the finest source for all your medicinal tincture needs. If you hear of anyone looking for an apothecary, send them our way. Oh, really, just send anyone our way. It's been so long since we've had a single customer.
Oh dear. Business not that good.
Welcome to K... Oh, really, just send anyone our way.
We've got the best herbs and potions in all of Eastshade. Tell your family, your friends, and random acquaintances to come here for all their apothecary needs.
We're starting to sound a little desperate. Well, I guess I'll leave you to it. I don't need an apothecary. Not just yet, anyway. Guess the eclipse is happening again. Reeds. Sure they'll be useful for something. Oh yes. Ooh. Eggs. Don't know why I'm picking them up, but I am. Well, something's going on here. I wonder. Looks like, that's no way to cross this river. Silver Falls. Okay. Certainly lots of places where we could be painting, but we have to be careful about canvases for the time being. We were making a fair bit of money, but who knows what we'll need to spend it on to get to places later. Definitely need to try and get that raft. It's clear now that we need it to cross somewhere. Ooh, more reeds. There we go.